Dr. Bhupesh Singh. Is going to talk to us on toric implantable columnal lenses in post-keratoplasty pseudophakic eyes for astigmatic management.
After the lot of refractive, now we are going to slightly on the lens-based refractive procedures. So toric implantable columnar lenses in post-keratoplasty pseudophakic eyes for astigmatism management. So as a cornea surgeon, it's very difficult to see post-op good quality corneas with having 4, 5, 6 cylinders and not happy with the outcome. They don't want to wear lenses because they are old. They don't want to go for laser because it's costly, as well it's risky for the graft survival. So the options are limited. So you have to give 6-cylinder glasses and other eyes normal 6-6. So it's difficult to balance the number also. So options are limited. So what can be done? So we have already discussed these things. So toric implantable columnar lens is one good option that I discovered recently because we are using in high myo patients. So I thought let's try in pseudophakic eyes. If all parameters are okay, like pentacam and AC depth and all are okay, why not in pseudophakic cases? So, and they are meant for sulcus implantation. So we tried using these lenses as a piggyback lens, post-keratoplasty pseudophakic eyes. So the aim was to evaluate the outcomes of toric implantable columnar lenses to correct residual astigmatism in post-keratoplasty pseudophakic patients. And we did 15 eyes in last 1 year, and AC depth was same to more than 2.8 millimeter, normal IOP, good endothelial count, and normal posterior segment, and all other pathologies we have excluded from our study. So this is one case that I want to show, 79-year-old male, and having corneal pasty, we did keratoplasty, and patient recovered well. Uncorrected visual acuity was 660 and N10, and refraction was 2.5 with 5-cylinder. Keratometry reading was 46.9 and 52. Rest everything was normal. AC depth was slightly more, 4.56, and rest was normal. So this was the pentacam map. You can see the K1 and K2, 46 and 52. Rest everything was normal. Pachymetry 500 micron. Then we did the same protocol, white-to-white measurement with sulcus on slit lamp, and it was 11.6. And we chose acryl ICL Biotech. The main reason for choosing this lens in my study is it's cheaper. So cost is another factor in India for all these cases. So it was chosen, and this was the surgery. So standard, like how we do toric IOLs, just mark the steep axis and the incisions. So you can see some sutures are still remaining. Because on these sutures, the patient's refraction was stable for 2 years. So that's why we have not touched it, so that because otherwise again it will change. So we have not removed few sutures. And this is the toric, acryl toric. Implantation is simple and it's easy than faking, because in faking you have to be very careful not to touch the lens and all those things. But in pseudophaking, if you can see the capsule rim nicely, there is no issue. You can handle it with ease. You can manipulate very comfortably. And surgery is done. So at 1 month post-op, the vault was slightly on the higher side, 901 micron, but at 3 months post-op, the vault was 750. And you can see the post-op, very clear, shiny cornea, and lens nicely sitting in place. So most of our patients have completed 1 year of follow-up, and patients are really doing well and happy without glasses. All old patients, 70 years, 80 years, with no glasses, with transplant is a miracle for them. And we also did the visual function index, and the satisfaction was more than 92% in comparison to glasses, where the satisfaction score was just 50%. The uncorrected visual acuity also increased significantly in post-operative period, and the spherical equivalent significantly decreased as expected. On one patient had high IOP in post-operative period, who came to normal after the standard anti-glaucoma medications. No other adverse effect was seen. And so the take-home message is, if patient is pseudophakic after keratoplasty, toric implantable columnar lenses should be considered for implantation in sulcus like a piggyback IOL. Thank you.
Thank you, Bhupesh. Very nice presentation. Just two questions. Why not the astigmatism was corrected by a lens, PCIOL?
No, so
because you are putting another lens in this eye, why the first surgeon or you as a phaco surgeon corrected the astigmatism and the refractive error at the first go?
No, so sir, most of the transplant patients are old patients, already operated somewhere, have a scar or trauma, all those cases.
So they were operated somewhere else.
All are operated somewhere else. Because otherwise,
and they had some refractive
otherwise error. So standard practice is go for keratoplasty, wait for a year, then go for IOL implantation. That is the standard practice. But mostly they are pseudophakic. That is the worst part.
And second, was the refraction stable in these patients?
Yes, so that's very important.
Because some of the video you showed had sutures.
I told
you. So when the suture dissolve or you somebody so cuts the suture, it is astigmatism is going to change.
So like my protocol is to remove the sutures one by one. After 6 months, I start removing. But once the refraction becomes stable, it's not changing significantly or not changing at all, there is no need to remove the sutures because suture impose another risk of rejection, infections and all those cases. So once refraction is stable in long-term post-op, don't remove sutures. You can leave it like that.
But that was not a columnar lens, it's a hydrophilic material.
Yeah, but they are meant for the sulcus implantation, so there is no risk. We are using phakic patient and these are
no, you mentioned it has a columnar lens.
Yeah, columnar.
This is a hydrophilic material, the lens you have used. Biotech is hydrophilic.
Hydrophilic material.
ICL is only columnar.
ICL is a different.
ICL is the only columnar,
yeah. But the cost factor is another constraint. So that's why I chose this because it's just 10,000 rupees lens.
Yes.
So were these?
So in some cases I got it customized from the company side, but mostly there was 6 diopter, 5 diopter. It's available in the inventory.
Why didn't you think of a sulcoflex instead of the?
There is some issue with the availability with sulcoflex because the radar has, I think, taken from the Delhi eye zone, and so we are not getting that. And cost is another factor. That's slightly costly lens, sulcoflex, in comparison with this lens.
Any comparison you know about between a sulcoflex and
so maybe that would be interesting study in future. We can implant a few patients with sulcoflex and then these patients and then compare the high rod aberration. That will be a good study.
The principle basically remains the same.
It's the
add-on lens.
Add-on lens.
Do you have any complications?
So we had high IOP in one patient, maybe some retained visco, but it is normal. One patient I had some pigment dispersion, iris pigment dispersion, but that was not affecting the visual acuity, visual quality, so no problem.
No
interface. No.
Any other study has been done? Any idea?
So one or two case reports I have seen, but no proper studies are there. So it's a new study, sir. Thank you, sir. No. Just the standard ICL calculation. You send the K1, K2, and AC depth to the company, and they will calculate and send the white to white. Same thing. Thank you. Thank you, sir.